Hello and welcome to my channel. Let's talk fuel economy so far. Welcome back and thanks for being here. My name is Scott, and when I last left you, I was wrapping up my leg in Death Valley. I was running a little low on fuel, but confident that I would make it to my fuel stop without needing to tap into the 5 gallons that I have in the trailer. I figured that I'd have about 3/16 of a tank left, and I got that really wrong. Thankfully, I didn't get it so wrong that I had to use any of that fuel back there, but I basically showed up here zero range, 7.5 miles to go to the fuel stop that I had intended to take. And I was targeting a Shell station, which that reminds me of how Google picks winners and losers. I'll get back to that in a second. But sure enough, as I was starting to get a little concerned, seeing I had 7.5 miles to go, but my range said zero, I looked down the road at one of the exits that was coming up, and I could see another Shell in the distance. So I took the exit, made it to the Shell station just fine, and refueled. The car took 12.3 gallons, which technically I had just under a gallon left in the tank, but we all know that it's not good to run the tank so low. Thankfully, a gallon is probably enough to keep the fuel pump cooled sufficiently, and of course I did not run out of fuel. But yeah, this trailer was, I had a lot of stiff headwinds coming out of Death Valley, and I guess my overall tank wasn't that bad. This tank, I got 22 miles of the gallon, so it's just amazing how fast that needle drops in the end. Let's see, Google, choosing winners and losers. I use Android Auto, and sometimes I will click the little, I forget what the icon looks like, but I'm looking to add a stop, and I'll say gas, find me gas or whatever. And it'll pull up gas. Now, I favor Shell stations, but realistically, I will fill up at any Exxon, BP, Mobil, any major brand. Most of them are top tier stations. And I don't think that Google particularly has something against Shell, because it does recommend Shell stations. But why didn't it recommend this one that's closer? There are times when it'll recommend a fuel station that's 20 miles away and completely overlook the one that's right in front of me. And so how is that? What criteria do they use to decide if they're going to recommend a fuel station or not? Show them all to me and let me choose. I don't know what kind of, you know, big tech is all about manipulating us. So what is it that they are deciding when they withhold information? I don't know. Is that conspiracy nut stuff? Comment below. So I don't know. It's just a little baffling. I was thankful to find this station, and now I'm topped off and ready to go for more. Overall fuel economy on the trip so far. Now, last time I didn't report all of this stuff until after I had done the whole trip. I figured I'd give you a small update. So far, I think I'm about 150 miles from my final destination. I am in Mojave, California right now, and I have driven 3,570 miles and burned 166.4 gallons. And that is an overall fuel economy of 21.45 miles per gallon. That, if I recall, is pretty close to what I got with the very unaerodynamic car utility trailer with exterior cargo. I was hoping that this cargo trailer would be a little bit more aerodynamic and therefore give me slightly better fuel economy. There are times when I do see slightly better. My best tank is 25.4 miles per gallon, and my worst was 16.9, and that was shocking. So I have to wonder if there are maybe some small deviations, variations in, did I not put in quite enough fuel or as much fuel as I could have here on this stop, or did I put in more than most of them on this one? So if I take off the top and the bottom, my best and my worst economy, then that would go to the next ones, which would be 24.7 and 18.4. And that's not bad. Most of my tanks seem to be in the 19 to 22 mile per gallon range. I think it was my most recent ones. Nevada, I got 25.4. and then going climbing into Pahrump, I guess, was when I got 19.6, and then my most recent one. My most recent tank, the one that I just filled up, most of the miles have been in California, where the speed limit for trailers is 55 miles per hour. And so I got 22 miles per gallon off of this tank, and that was including descending from Pahrump down into the Death Valley, but also going up and over a 5,000 foot mountain pass. And I'm not quite sure what my elevation is right now, but I've been driving in some pretty stiff winds today. I don't know. I'll let you know if my miles per gallon in California stays high, 22 miles per gallon being high. But that's what I have to report so far. There was something else that I was going to report to you that's fuel related, but I just can't quite remember what it is. I remember what I was going to bring up. For miles per gallon, selection of the vehicle. Now, there are a lot of GTI owners that are just completely cringing that I am traveling across the country twice, four times if you count it round trips, four times with a trailer in tow. In the last video, I had some people say, why didn't you rent a van, rent a whatever? And well, first, if I do that, then it won't be a cross-country trip in a GTI for my small car slash Volkswagen channel. So I gotta use the GTI. It's the content, man. But I gotta say, renting out wouldn't have happened because they charge you by the mile anyway. It would have just been more expensive to rent a vehicle. Sure, less wear and tear on this car, but I'm making the drive and I'm paying for mileage anyway. I might as well just put it on the car. But I have to say, in one of my previous videos, I don't remember the subject. Oh, it was the poll results slash results of the rebranding, my decision about rebranding the channel. I had speculated that if a tree were to fall on my GTI today, I would be equally split between buying another GTI, a Ford Transit Connect, and a Subaru Crosstrek. Now, I have looked really hard at these minivans, without really minivans, I guess you can call them a microvan, the Ford Transit Connect and the Ram ProMaster City. Both have my attention. There are some really neat conversions done on them. And between the two, I think the Transit is a better looking van, and I think it has a more car-like feel in the front, which of course appeals to me. Both of them are made for drivers to just sit in them all day long, so they're reportedly very comfortable to drive. I was so tempted to buy one of those two vans for this trip, because if I had a Ford Transit Connect, either of them really, the Ford or the Ram, but I would have chosen the Transit Connect. I wouldn't need to pull this trailer. I would have cargo space behind me. It would be locked up inside the van, and that van with its cargo would still get anywhere from 25 to 28 miles to the gallon. And given the way I drive, it might even do better. I've always beat EPA fuel economy estimates. So I don't know, but at least 26, I'm sure I could get 26 out of it. And that's better than this. And so it was really tempting. And then the closer it came time to punch out and go, I just abandoned the idea. But yes, I could have done something that would have gotten better fuel economy. I mean, heck, even a VW Atlas with all the cargo inside would have gotten better fuel economy than what I'm seeing right now. But that's a whole lot more expensive than a Ford Transit Connect. Anyway, I just wanted to come back and let you know that I remembered what I was thinking about. See ya. Next, I will be going to my final destination, where I will take on some cargo, and then that might change my miles per gallon as well. We'll see. As always, I appreciate you being here. Please subscribe if you're interested. I will see you next time. Take care.